there I am. Everywhere I go, there I am.
And you go, hi-ho,
hi-ho. Hi-ho, hi-ho, hi-ho.
Don't be a ho. Hi, I'm Jesse. This is my lovely wife, Seaweed, and we are Tribal Soup Project. Welcome to another episode of Fare Antics, simple fare for simple folk, a low-carb cooking show with a bit of a twist. And today we're going to be making...
Well, Milani, we're going to be making the corned beef and cabbage.
Oh, be golly.
Do you like my lucky charms?
No.
I don't like my lucky charms. I thought he was charming.
That's fucking... Could you do it louder? Oh, that was a very nice baga. A very nice baga indeed. I'm very proud of your baga ability.
Well, one baga gets another.
Your mom gets a baga. She gets it all night long. She gets that baga.
Right. Your mom's a good baga.
Hey! Too much, you say too much.
Too much.
Oh, you can't see. Oh, wait.
Hey, you're smashing my head.
No, I was poking you in your eye.
So the ingredients you're going to need to make corned beef and cabbage, you're going to need a piece of corned beef. I have got about a 2.5 pound piece of meat here, and I usually get the kind that has the little seasoning packet already in it, because the seasoning within that packet seemed to really complement the meat. We're also going to be making cabbage, and we're going to be doing that on a skillet. So you're going to need cabbage and bacon and whatever seasonings you like to use for your vegetables, but I probably am just going to use salt and pepper. So in order to do the corned beef, we're going to use a slow cooker for this. And I'm going to put my piece of meat into my slow cooker. And then I'm just going to pick it up and bring it over here, and I'm going to put enough water into it to cover my piece of meat. That's roughly about 4 to 6 cups of water. So now that I have my meat in the water, I'm just going to open my seasoning packet here and sprinkle it in. Like so. And depending on the size of your meat and your appliance that you're using, you want to cook the meat in the slow cooker. If you're going to do it on low like I am, you're going to want to cook it in there from anywhere from 5.5 to 8.5 hours. If you put it on a high setting, it could be done in about 3.5 to 4.5 hours. So we're going to go ahead and get that going. And I will see you guys in a few hours to make the cabbage. Roughly about 6 hours later, and I am ready to go ahead and start cooking my cabbage. I am going to fry it into a pan with some bacon. So first I'm going to go ahead and cut up my bacon. And then I'm just going to go ahead and put it in my pan over about medium high heat. And once the bacon starts to brown, I'm going to go ahead and add my cabbage in with that. Okay, put it on the heat, like I said, at about medium high, somewhere in there. And now I'm going to go ahead and cut up my cabbage. What do you think you're doing? Don't make me.
You know your dad's asleep.
Oh my God, Jesse, that I can't believe you had me do. You're in so much trouble, Jesse.
Whatever.
That's messed up. How dare you do that with my dad's
funny.
Sleeping? This is my funny nose.
Well, yeah.
Do you see it?
I see it. How could you not see your funny nose? It's right there in your face. You could sing a Rush song right now. Sing like something from Rush.
No. You know I'm bad. You know it. Alright, so now that my bacon is pretty much all cooked, I'm just going to go ahead and add my cabbage. Give it a nice little mix. When it begins to wilt and you have all of your cabbage covered with the bacon grease, you can go ahead and cover it and let it finish cooking out until it wilts. To be about 145 degrees Fahrenheit in the middle. Thorns in the cracks in my hips and the dents in my car and the blisters off my lips that I'm not the carefulest of girls. It's not the way I'm meant to be. It's just the way the operation made me. Pretending that I'm you.
For dinner again.
Hats all beneath the surface, trying to convince you it was accidentally on purpose.
Oh, no, you know, it wasn't purposely accidental.
I meant only that the rebound only on a rare occasion. The rest of the lie as a girl on anachronism. In my hair is the best of all time, but not right now at all. There I go again, pretending that I'll fall. Don't call the doctors, they've seen it all before. They'll say, just let her crash and burn, she'll learn.
The attention just occurred to her.
Yes, like you're sorry you did that. You did everything you could, like any decent person would. But this is the little thing, for instance.
The way the medication makes her.
I am the girl anachronism. I am the girl anachronism. I am the girl anachronism. There we are with our finished corned beef and cabbage. Mm.
and thanks for watching this episode of Fare Antics. We do appreciate you guys stopping by. Check out our subscribe button down there. Hit the like button. Share us with your friends on Facebook or other social media. Stop by our website and see what Travel Soup Project is all about.
Until next time, guys. Happy cooking and happy living. Bye.